To allow us to move on to more talented speaking, I would like at this time to introduce the chairman of the State Democratic Party, the founder of the J. Jacobs Grant Fund for the New York State Young Democrats, the chairman of the State Party, J. Jacobs.
Thank you. I want to thank Kevin and the entire executive committee of the Young Democrats for all the work they're doing. Let's give them again another big round of applause. When Kevin asked me to come this evening, he said he would be having a fundraiser. And I know how difficult fundraising is. And I tell you, there are those of you here tonight who in not too many years are going to look to run for office, are going to help others run for office, work on campaigns. And I think you know, and I don't need to remind you that fundraising is the toughest part of this job. And it's interesting, when I asked about how much the ticket price was going to be, because he wanted me to come and speak and be a draw for the crowd, and he told me the ticket price, and it seems that the beer, actually, that he's giving away for free is worth more than some of the tickets people are buying. I understood quite how the value has dropped in my speaking. Now, interestingly enough, when I got my start as Nassau County Democratic Chairman in 2001, some of you may remember Tom Swasey. We ran a tough primary. I became the county chairman. Now, I'll be honest with you, I didn't know what county chairman was all about. I didn't know what the job was. I knew I had to raise money. I absolutely hated raising money. And I went to my wife when they asked me to run for this, and I sold her a bill of goods, really. I told her, wouldn't be too many hours, wouldn't take much out of my bed. I'm just going to do this thing on the side. And she, you know, looked askance at it and said, okay. So sure enough, I go out, and I'm working. One of the things I'm doing is fundraising. But it seems it's easy, because Tom Swasey has won a primary. We're going to take over Nassau County for the first time from the Republicans. And there are law firms and developers and builders. Everybody wants to get in on the action. So what do you know? We have a finance chairman. People are calling up. They want to meet me, the new chairman. My finance chairman gets smart. She says, we're not going to have you meet these people for free. We have to raise money for the campaign. So, all legal, no quid pro quo, she makes an arrangement. You want to have breakfast with Mr. Jacobs, it's going to be $1,000. How about that? If you want lunch with the chairman, it's going to be $2,500. And if you want dinner with the chairman, it's $5,000. I thought she was crazy. Well, she puts that out. Before you know it, my calendar is booked. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner, I'm going place to place, and the party is racking in the money. Everything is going easy. It's going great. We've got a big campaign. I've got to bring in these dollars. And I'm talking to these folks. No promises. No, nothing unseemly about it. But here's how we're making the money. One evening, I come home, and there's my wife standing in the kitchen. I haven't been home in days. And she is pissed. And she looks at me and she said, this is not what you said it was going to be. And I said, Mindy, you just don't understand. She said, I'm not happy. I said, you're not looking at this the right way. I said, I want you to think about it. Now, just think about it. I've got people who are paying $1,000 to have breakfast with me. There are other people paying $2,500 to have lunch with me. There are yet other people paying $5,000 to have dinner with me. And you're getting to sleep with me for free. Needless to say, she did not take advantage of that great bargain for quite a few weeks. But I thought it was fun. But fundraising is, I have to tell you, the toughest part of the job. It has not been as easy since. And I do a lot of it. But I'm here tonight, and I'm going to be very brief, because you're here to have fun. But I would be remiss if I didn't speak just for a few short moments about what it is to be a young Democrat and what it means in this time, in this country, at this hour, to be a Democrat, be proud of it, and be working toward our mutual goals. I want you to think about something. Just this past weekend in Washington, we averted a government shutdown by giving in, as I think we had to do, on $38 billion more cuts in our federal budget. Now that may just seem like numbers to some people, but it's going to mean a real impact to the lives of many. You've seen what's going on out in Wisconsin. You see the mood of this country. Now more than ever, Democrats have to step up and grasp onto what our principles are and our values are, because this country is headed in the wrong direction. When we have a country that all of a sudden wakes up and decides that the most important problem we have is our debt, in the throes of the worst recession this country has seen, the worst economic climate since the Great Depression, I think we're making a mistake, particularly when it's going to cost the neediest among us the most. I want to leave you with this. You think about it. George Bush was elected president in 2000. Between 2000 and 2007, 100% of the economic growth in income in this country was retained by the top 10% of the people. The income disparity in America is going to be our greatest problem. We as Democrats have to remember something. We're here for a reason. We're Democrats for a reason. We have to stand up and fight, and I don't want anybody to step back at any time, no matter what the opposition may say, and be afraid to stand up and say that this country was founded on certain principles. The Democratic Party has stood by them. If not for the Democrats, you wouldn't have Social Security, you wouldn't have Medicare, you wouldn't have Medicaid, you wouldn't have workers' compensation, and a whole host of other things that have been great for the working people, the average people in this country. We stand tall. You young Democrats, well, you take a look. This is what the effects of time has on a young Democrat. This is what you get. But you keep fighting, and I'm telling you, it's worth it. What you're doing makes a difference. Thank you all very much.